Many scholars talk different ways on the same topic, which scholar should be followed. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As I was talking earlier in my earlier lecture, that we should not stick ourselves to one scholar. The scholar are nothing but just like similar open opinion for you. What you have to stick with that, you have to stick it with the Quran, and you have to stick to the understanding of the Quran and learn the tafsir of the Quran, and then you read all the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then you are able to filter the hadith, and you have to know what is the classification of hadith, what is the science of hadith, and you will be able to make a filter, and you will come to know which one is sahih, which one is daif, and which is fabricated, and hasan hadith, and so you will be able to classify them. But rather after Allah and after the Messenger of Allah, every scholar have their own opinion. So the question was asked, which scholar to follow? So first of all, I'm going to very clarify something. Any scholar who says Allah is one and Allah is alone doer, number one, he's correct, he's right. If someone believes on the grave worshipping, and if someone has a special appearance, and if someone start talking about something else, like this Ali has a power, that Wali has a power, this Buzurg has a power, do not follow that scholar. He's not authentic. He's just teaching shirk. He's teaching a shirk, so it's forbid them. Now come to the scholar, any scholar who believes Allah is one, and who believes Allah is a lone doer, no wali, no buzurg, no elder, no special powered, a blessed person, no one, they are nothing except one Allah. And someone who believes on the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now this is something where is a confusing part. Some people give the priority to their scholars, their leaders on the top of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they are getting misguided. So rather you go back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So anybody who's following the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and teaching the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam the hadith, you can follow them. But if somebody's teaching, okay, this scholar says that, and that buzurg says that, and we have a 200 years ago that scholar came, passed away, and he gave this fatwa, and he gave this fatwa, and he was a very blessed person, and he was a very he has a great knowledge, and he was a big scholar, he was a hafiz, he was a distance, forget it, who cares, don't even bother listening to this type of a scholar. You don't need to stay away from them, that's it. So we have a scholar who is teaching a shirk, we cut them. Who's teaching about the leaders who has been giving a fatwas from their scholars, cut them off. You need to follow the fatwa of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is our main fatwa, that is our main teaching that we have to follow. Other than all the scholars have a different opinion, so we are cleared who should we follow. We should be follow who talks about the Prophet, who talks about the education, who does not talk about like, oh, we have a good scholar who was being passed away and he taught us this book, and let's read this book, so throw him away. You don't need to follow that. If I have my Quran in my hand and I'm teaching you Quran, you can follow me. If I'm giving you a sahih hadith, you can follow me. But if I come with some book written by me, and I would say that, okay, I am saying this and I'm saying that, and I'm saying that, you follow me, so just throw it away. If I'm saying that there's 100, 200 years ago, there was a great scholar, he has memorized the whole Quran, he recited the Quran every day, he was being very blessed, he has a lot of shifa in his head, hand, he was a very blessed, and he has done a lot of work of a deen. Very good, mashallah, very good. He's going to get a great status in the Jannah. But any scholar is not allowed to teach the other the scholars' books which is passed away, but rather even some scholar is teaching a book, that book should be the Quran and the hadith, sahih hadith. So this is something very sensitive. Any scholar's book you can read, but you have to make sure the scholars of the any author who wrote the book, you need to make sure his akida was pure, because most of the books in the market those are following Sufism, and they believe on Tasawwuf, and they believe on their elders, and they're telling the stories of their elders, and they're telling about the miracles of their elders. So you don't need to follow them. Throw that away. You need to go back to the scholars who are teaching the Quran and who are teaching the Sahih Hadith. Who any scholar that is teaching other than this, you do not need to follow the scholars. Like, for example, if you ask me what do I teach, I teach Quran, and I restrict myself to Quran and the Sahih Hadith, and that's my restrictions. And everything else, I respect every scholar. I respect all the four scholars, and there are many scholars, not only four scholars, and I take their opinion as an opinion, but I do not restrict myself to one scholar. Like, for example, I do not restrict myself to just follow Imam Abu Hanifa Rahmatullahi, or I'm going to follow Imam Shafi, Imam Ibn Hanbal, or Imam Malik. I do not restrict myself. I kept myself broad, and I restrict myself to the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then it is up to you whose opinion you like it. You can accept it or you want to reject it. It's up to you. But rather you restrict yourself to the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So any scholar who has been teaching and talking about the Quran and who is teaching about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just stick to that. But if someone comes and say, okay, like 200 years ago there was a great scholar who was born in India, and there was a great scholar who was born in Pakistan, and their fatwa books are in the market, and their followers are following their fatwas, this is wrong to do that, because they are getting misguided. Because they, first of all, they are not supposed to be following their scholars. They're supposed to be following, going back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, and what is the Quran talking about that, and then they have to investigate. But do not restrict to the person of the scholar who was passed away 200 years ago and in India, was born in India and Pakistan like 200 years ago in some other country. You are not supposed to be following that, because your next generation will be more misguided if you are following a scholar, so they're going to be following some other scholars. So rather you restrict your limit to up to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you're going to be staying on the right path. You will be saved. Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, those who will stick to the teachings of the Quran and the Sunnah, they will be the one who will be survived.